tonight's episode of Zap Pronto, The Problem with Pergo. This episode was brought to you by Belcher Brewery. Everyone who drinks Belchers is young and sexy.
You can be too.
Drink Belchers. Deep within the vast reaches of space, wrapped in riddles, packed with puzzles, mass and mystery, engulfed in enigma is the planet Pergo. It lies at the center of a vast empire, ruled with an iron fist by the ruthless Emperor Dung the Humorless. Let's go now to his throne room to witness the birth of his evil plot.
Oh good, he's not here.
We shall have him report to him eventually. We are his personal minion.
Well, I'm not in any hurry. I'm getting the feeling that he's up to something, and I don't like it when he's up to something. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put on my television goggles, and I'm going to watch more transmissions from that planet Earth, because I like... No. I love Lucy! Freaky way!
We shall wait here.
Any spoil sport?
Remember, we shall not speak of the incidents on Murgatroyd.
But, heavens to Murgatroyd! We gotta tell him.
I will do the talking and reveal only what is necessary. You will keep your mouth shut.
Okay, mum's the word.
What is that?
That's crap. I got it from Planet Amazon. It's great prices and free shipping.
It does not resemble any crab species of which I am aware.
It's canine replicant android buddy.
A robot dog?
Yes, and an ill-tempered robot dog at that.
This hardly seems the appropriate place for pets.
He's not really a pet. He's completely equipped to defend his owner.
Equipped?
Yes. Flamethrowers, rocket launchers, the usual.
Really?
Yes, really.
I thought I sent you two idiots elsewhere.
Your Majesty!
We just returned from the planet Murgatroyd, Your Highness.
Tell me now, how fares our reign over that wretched dump? Is there any news?
No, sir. There is absolutely no news to report.
Just say no.
Everything is as it was when you conquered it.
You know, I was really hoping for some word of the suffering I've inflicted. It does so lift my spirits. Tell me of any little misery, no matter how trifling.
No, sir. There is no news. Nothing at all. Nothing except, well, there is just one little thing, since you're so anxious to know. Doesn't amount to anything at all. But since you've been away, your horta died.
He's dead, Jim.
My horta's dead? Who dared to kill my horta?
Well, you see, the horta ate some bird gremlin tail.
A hunk hunk of bird in love.
And that's what killed the horta, eating bird gremlin tail? Where did he get the bird gremlin tail to eat?
Well, you see, when the royal stables burned down, and burned up all the gremlin and the kobali, and then the horta went in after the fire, he pulled off and ate some of the bird gremlin tail. That's what killed the horta.
What? My stables burned down?
Oh, yes. Burned to the ground.
Well, how did the stables catch fire?
Well, a spark flew over from the palace and caught the stables on fire, and the stables burned down with the gremlin and the kobali inside, and then after the fire cooled off, the horta went in and ate some of the burnt gremlin tail, and that's what killed the horta.
Holy house fire, Batman!
So, my palace is burned too?
Yes, that's completely destroyed the flames. The flames were glorious.
And how did the palace catch fire?
Well, the honor guard, you see, we were performing the 21 laser salute, and somebody's weapon got a little out of control, and then a spark flew up from the palace and got the stables on fire, and the stables burned to the ground with all the livestock in it, and then after the fire cooled off, the horde went and ate some burnt rabbit tail, and that's what killed the horde.
And why were they performing a 21 laser salute?
It was for the funeral.
Funeral? Whose funeral?
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Yes, that's the other little thing I forgot to mention. Since you've been away, your mother-in-law died.
Ding dong, the witch is dead. Witch of witch, witch, ding dong, the witch is dead.
Wait a minute! Are you certain?
Yes, sir, quite dead.
Oh, okay. Tell me, what killed my mother-in-law?
Well, it's hard to say for sure, but rumor in the court is that she died of shock from your wife running away with your shuttle pilot.
May the force be with you, Han Solo.
Drat, it's so hard to get good shuttle pilots these days. What's his problem?
that recently discovered planet Earth. They're most interesting.
Tell me more about this planet.
Well, one of their favorite contests is called Vast Bowl.
Take me out to the ball game.
Tell me more about this Vast Bowl.
There are two small armies involved. The object appears to be to hit a ball with a stick, and then touch certain spots on the ground until you get back to where you started. The other army attempts to thwart this. Now as we gather to view the spectacle.
And the crowd goes wild!
And if they are thwarted, they die?
No, they stop on one of the spots where they retreat from the field.
You're out,
cowards!
The army of thwarters is larger than the one trying to hit the ball.
Ah, a massacre!
No, there are arbitrators to prevent that.
Safe!
Wimps.
Sometimes they steal.
Oh, now that's better. No. What do they steal?
One of the spots on the ground.
Must be some valuable property.
Eventually, someone is declared the winner and everyone goes home.
Well, come hit the dugout, boys!
And they take their plunder with them.
No, they leave everything where it was.
Well, it's all over but the crying.
Well, these fools certainly seem ripe for the plucking.
Shall we warm up the planetary disintegrator?
Go ahead. Make my day.
No, I think I shall toy with them first. Let's see. What foul things can I torment them with before I send my legions to force their submission to my will and steal all their bases? A plague of locusts? No, that's too quick. I can cause their sun to explode. No, that's been done to death. I really want to watch them squirm.
Like a bug in her magnifying glass.
Nothing says loving like something from the oven.
That's it!
What?
I will prepare my secret interstellar heat ray, point at this planet Earth, and set it to increase the temperature by a small amount every year!
I'm afraid I can't let you do that, Dave.
I told you I'm not Dave! We shall witness their feeble attempts to alleviate the problem. They shall recycle aluminum cans. They shall drive hybrids and add insulation to their homes. They shall elect Democrats!
No!
But still, their crops will fail. Their ice caps will melt. And their beachfront condos will be underwater. By the time they have figured out what has happened, it'll be too late!
Wow, he's intense.
He's the supreme ruler of most of the known universe.
Yeah, well, I'm just saying he needs to loosen up a little bit, that's all.
You're most disrespectful, spouting all that nonsense.
Well, you know what I'm going to do, because I'm going to turn these back on because Game of Thrones is coming on, and
But no! I can watch Game of Thrones on the phone! Don't me!
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that today's episode of Zap Pronto is brought to you by Zap Pronto Cereal. All natural and organic with no added salt or sugar. It provides Zap with 110% of the vitamins and minerals he needs for accomplishing heroic deeds. Zap Pronto Cereal. Maybe your kids will eat it because Zap's picture's on the box. Our hero, Zap Pronto, has signed a new multi-year contract to play baseball for the Alabaster Albatrosses. Intrepid reporter Gale Arden has always admired Zap's talent, but never dreamed she would get to meet him.
Arden here.
Oh, yes, of course I want to interview Zap Pronto. Who wouldn't? Here. Well, I am now. Well, of course, yes, she thinks fine. Oh, an exclusive interview with Zap Pronto! Hi. So, Zap, new team, new league. In what ways do you feel you can contribute?
Yeah, well, I'm working hard, staying focused, giving 110%, trying to have fun out there. I'm seeing the ball real good, but baseball's a funny game, so I'd rather be lucky than good because that's the way a ball bounces. It's a no-brainer, you do the math.
Who told you to say that?
My agent. So my usual statements don't make much sense.
Yeah, that's a no-brainer. Say, do us both a favor and just answer in your own words, okay?
When you're enlightened, every word is wisdom.
Okay, Buddha, then enlighten me. What are some of your impressions of your new teammates?
Well, I don't really do impressions. Might hurt someone's feelings, but, we got this one guy who kind of talks like, I need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle. He's starting to run out of clothes because he keeps on borrowing them.
Okay. Borrows clothes. Got it. Say, I'm new to the beat, so why don't you start with their names? Tell me the names of the guys on your team.
Yeah, well, they have some very peculiar names.
Oh, peculiar.
Yeah, it's very unusual. We got, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
Oh, see, that's what I'm trying to find out. I want you to tell me the names of the guys on your team.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third. Hey,
you know the guys' names.
Yes.
Alright, well then tell me the guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy on first base.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who's on first?
Well, what are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. Who's on first?
No, I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name?
That's whose name?
Yes.
When they pay the first baseman, who gets the money?
Every dollar, but why not? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So who gets it?
Why shouldn't he? Sometimes his wife comes down and collects it, but I mean...
Who's wife?
Oh, yes. After all, man earns it.
Who does?
Absolutely.
You. You gotta get outfield?
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay, then the left fielder's name.
What?
Oh, I don't know, I just thought I'd ask.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
Alright, well then tell me, who's playing left field?
No, who's playing first?
No, stay on the infield. The left fielder's name.
What?
The guys.
Oh, he's center field.
You got a pitcher on this team?
Now wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
Ah, okay, well then tell me the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
Me, if I were being a catcher, I'd want to take the ball and throw it to first base. So I pick up the ball and I throw it to...
That's the first thing you said right.
Oh, I don't even know what I'm talking about!
Excited. Take it easy.
So the guy on first throws to what? And what throws it to? I don't know, and I don't know. It takes it all the way back to center. A triple play.
Yeah, that could be.
Yeah, and then there's that long ball to center.
Because?
Because? I don't know, and I don't care.
What was that?
I said I don't care.
Oh, he's a shortstop.
So lucky I have a phone call. Arctic here. Yes! Bye! Okay, yes! Dude, what day?
Who was that?
Let's not start that again.
You seem troubled. Only troubled people seek peace.
Famous reclusive scientist, Chase Grant, is offering me an exclusive interview if I could just get to his office in the next 15 minutes.
Well, I can get you there.
Oh, I'm sure you can.
Sorry?
Oh, just come on. Okay.
To the person who wanted Zap Pronto's walking space, have a great day.
Zap Pronto is the most interesting man in Alabaster. He never drinks beer, but if he did, he'd drink Belchers. At Belchers, we hope you believe that drinking, or simply holding a bottle of our beer, will make you cool. Bye, Belchers, even if you don't drink it. Meanwhile, back on the planet Pergo, the evil overlord Dung the Merciless is gloating over his latest nefarious plan. The inhabitants of Earth argue with each other over hanging chads and who should be the next American Idol, while each day the planet grows a little warmer.
Yes, yes, everything is going exactly as planned!
You will be assimilated.
Indeed.
Boss!
What do you idiots want now?
We're sorry to interrupt your gloating, your awesome wickedness, but the princess is here to see you.
Ah! My lord, the princess? Here? What is she up to?
We don't know. We've been hanging around to find out.
She seemed exceedingly pleased with herself.
She's not armed, is she?
I don't think so.
No detectable weapons, but with the princess, that doesn't mean much.
Oh, yes, just like her mother, my ninth wife, Cruella. Oh, what a beautiful temper she had, and such long, elegant, white fangs. What are you two just standing there for? Show her in! And hold my calls!
Hello, Father.
Hello, Poopsie.
Father, I wish you wouldn't call me that. It's not good for my image.
But you'll always be my Poopsie.
Just don't let the servants hear you.
Okay, Poopsie. Now, what brings you here? Have you perhaps come for some fatherly advice on making the lives of everyone around you living hell?
No, Father. I mastered all of that in high school.
Oh, yes, yes. You were a true prodigy. Well, how about some tips on empire building?
I conquered 3 galaxies before finishing college.
Ah, well, how about some wisdom on the merits of ruling with an iron fist?
I assure you that my boot heel remains planted firmly on their throats.
Oh, well, how about some guidance on the finer points of avoiding assassination?
Father, I didn't come here for advice.
No? You're not here to kill me, are you? Gods!
No, Father. Don't you know? It's too soon for that.
Oh, yes, yes. I'm well aware of all the details of that family tradition. But your generation doesn't seem to have any regard for traditional family values.
Father, I'm here to celebrate the festival of the ravenous red locust. That magical time of year when the locusts rise up and strip the planet of every living thing. I can still remember as a little girl standing on the parapet and watching as the voracious swirling cloud crests the northern mountain and flows down into the valley like a crimson tide, decimating all they wash over. Only the foul stench of their decomposing bodies as they begin to run out of things to consume and die of starvation.
Ravenous red locust day already? Where has the year gone?
It is a time to reflect and recount the deeds of the past year.
Oh, come to brag, have we?
Yes, Father, if you'd like to call it that.
Well, out with it then. What new depths of depravity have you plumbed?
Oh, Father, you do have a way with words.
Come on, girl. Hit me with your best shot.
Well, let's see. I TP'd your particle accelerator.
That was you? But it rained that morning. I was so deliciously angry.
Your turn.
I had all your clothes taken up an inch while you were asleep.
What? I was on a diet for a month.
Yes, I quite enjoyed that.
Well, I had the ringtone of every phone on the planet Verizon permanently set to It's a Small World.
I had the entire nudist planet Nirvana covered in itching powder.
I collapsed the economy of a planet with the use of overleveraged derivatives of subprime loans.
I have no idea what that means.
Neither do they.
I canceled Christmas!
Now, I don't know what that is.
Neither do I, but it really seemed to upset the natives.
I outlawed bathing.
The only clothing allowed on the ice planet of Hoth are spandex pants and 2 tops!
I have decreed that only one clerk may work in the DMV at a time, even though there are positions for many.
I kicked a puppy!
Sorry, you didn't!
No, I didn't. There are things even I won't do.
Well, that's all I can think of.
Oh! I almost forgot! I have found a new planet to torment. Even as we speak, the interstellar heat ray is slowly creating environmental chaos!
Exterminate!
I heard about that. How's it going?
Oh, wonderfully. At first they just denied that it was happening, but now they're slowly beginning to thrash about and blame each other!
You win, Father.
Oh, come now, Poopsie. Someday you will be as evil as I.
I can only hope so, Father.
Now then, let us mount the parapet and behold the glory of the coming of the ravenous red locusts.
Don't you just love royalty?
What are you talking about? You practically wet yourself every time they look at you.
Well, I didn't say I wasn't scared of them. I just love the way they hold themselves. Their stately attire, their courtly manners, their supreme confidence. Ooh, I could show you my scrapbook.
They are an anachronism. They should have no standing in the modern world.
How can you say that? They're born and raised to be the ruling elite. No one is more qualified to govern. Can you imagine the Prime Minister wielding the ceremonial death saber?
Huh. Are you suggesting that birthright is a logical system for assigning ruling authority? You might as well designate the leader to be someone who can pull a sword out of a stone.
Well, it'd have to be a magic sword, but yes, that would work.
Can't you see that the fulfillment of the will of the people is the proper role of government, and that aristocracy is inherently so disconnected from the masses, they only strive to fulfill their own personal agendas and to perpetuate their legacy.
Socialist.
That's not the what you seem to think it is. Besides, socialism is a utopian economic structure that vests the ownership of the production and distribution of the community as a whole. It is not a system of government.
lifestyle of the monarch.
Ah, spoilsport. Where's your sense of romance? Castles, royal weddings, coronations. Don't you just love them?
A waste of resources.
Come on, wouldn't you want to be a knight arrayed in gleaming armor off on a noble quest?
They turned me down.
What?
I applied for the squire position and was rejected 8 times.
I'm so sorry. Do you want to talk about it? I know how you feel.
I did not wish to discuss it.
But we could have some tea and we could talk about it. Oh, and I could show you my scrapbook.
Remember to trust your retirement to the Financial Institute of Zap. Invest your money with Fizz. You'll never have to worry about it again. Zap Pronto rushes the intrepid reporter Gale Arden to her meeting with the famous reclusive scientist in his plug-in electric hybrid. He is waiting for them in his laboratory with news that will shake the very foundations of their beliefs.
My analysis is complete.
I have almost perfect correlation. No doubt about it. Of course I'm sure.
Look,
my algorithm's finding a frog's hair split 4 ways, but you're gonna be happier than a pig in a slop. I'll get her done!
Hello?
Excuse me, I have visitors.
Oh.
There you are. Oh man, you're a sight for sore eyes. Have I got something to tell you?
All right, what is it, Professor?
I have discovered how to make a radio out of Milo's tea and a Birmingham Barons cap.
Really?
You called me all the way out here to tell me that? Surely you're joking.
Not joking, and don't call me sir.
Wow, that's awesome.
Professor, Babe Ruth here nearly killed us trying to get us here in time, and you said you had something to tell us that could affect the survival of the entire planet.
Oh, yeah. Don't touch me!
Well, are you gonna tell us, or do I need Zip here to take you for a little ride?
That'd be great. We could take a ride down the coast, but if Benny's diner, hey, I know this great guy.
I have discovered the cause of global warming.
SUVs.
Oh!
Cow farts.
Oh!
Outdoor?
No!
Okay, can we quit with any questions? Professor, what have you discovered?
I have discovered a strange radiation attacking the Earth previously unknown to man.
God, sooks!
Dead zooks indeed, and that was before Ben the Sun!
And this mysterious radiation is what's causing the Earth to become warmer.
Yes. By my calculations, if the temperature continues to rise, the Earth will become uninhabitable to humans in approximately 23.5 years.
That's not good.
Thank you, Captain Obvious.
You're welcome.
Professor, are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. I'll triple check right after breakfast.
Well, is there anything we can do?
Oh, sure. Mankind can move underground until the climate corrects itself. Deep within the Earth, the temperature remains a constant. We would only need to locate caves at the proper altitude to be able to withstand the flooding from the melting of the poles.
Well, would we be down there forever? Hey, bad.
It's hard to say, but eventually a black hole in the galaxy would become between us and interrupt the beam. It's hard to be exact, but by my calculations, we would only have to stay down there approximately 157 years, 21 days, 16 hours, and 9 seconds.
Peckos, watch.
Whoa.
So, are you trying to tell me that mankind could actually survive down there for 100 and whatever years?
Oh, easily. Nuclear and geothermal power, hydroponics for oxygen, and bills. We would only need to take DNA from the proper species who might not survive the ordeal. The whole Noah's Ark thing.
Yeah, but would there be room for everybody down there? Would there be baseball?
No, but there would be enough room to take enough people to guarantee the genetic diversity necessary to repopulate the species.
Oh, and who decides who goes and who stays?
Well, that's as easy as falling off the log, sugar. It would be done scientifically, of course, taking into consideration the necessary skills, health, genetics,
fertility.
There would, however, have to be a ratio of 10 women for every man. It would have to be maintained in order for the population to be repopulated more rapidly.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, that would necessitate the end of monogamy.
Well, you do what you gotta do. I mean, there's a first time for everything.
Hey, sign me up, Doc.
Hey, simmer down, fat boy. And you simmer down, too. Now, Professor, that just sounds like giving up. We can't just run into these caves like a bunch of little scared rabbits. Wait, where's that can-do spirit that makes this the greatest country on Earth? Where would we be if the pioneers just turned tail and things got a little tough? Or if Lewis and Clark didn't have a map?
Nowhere.
That's exactly what. Or what if George Washington got a little cold and he surrendered? Would you like that? I wouldn't. Do you think? Put those down. Do you think that the pioneers, when they came across a river that was too big, they just turned tail? No, they did not!
No, ma'am.
No, they caught them with wagons and they floated them across. This country is founded on the grit and determination of ordinary people. Seeking a better life, as well as the geniuses like Alexander Graham Bell and Thomas Edison.
Amen.
So, Professor, we can't just let this happen. There has to be something you can do. Come on, think, man!
Oh,
yeah!
We could stop the radiation at the source.
You know the source?
Yes, I took a check right before lunch.
Lunch. I missed lunch.
By my calculations of using my radio telescope, I predict that it's coming from somewhere from a planet in the Crab Nebula.
Crab.
a planet? Not a quasar or a pulsar or something like that?
It's a planet, all right. I checked again while I ate my vittles.
Well, is there anything? Do you think the radiation is natural?
Oh, there's nothing natural about it. The beam is focused and remains focused on the Earth. Even as the planets continue to revolve around their suns and the galaxy rotates around its core, there's nothing natural about this at all.
I suspect foul play.
As do I.
We're under attack?
I reckon so.
My aliens! My little green men!
That's the spot!
My calculations, I would only say that there may be a 3% chance that they're green. And there may not be any men! Or women, for that matter!
Well, maybe we can pay them a visit. We can have a chat, we can resolve our differences.
That is the smartest thing you've said yet, Zipper. But we don't have a way to get to another planet, so we're doomed and all is lost!
Well, yeah, hello! I have a spaceship!
Oh, cool. Can I see it? Can I fly it?
You have a spaceship.
Yeah, and it's right out in the backyard in between the nuclear reactor and the highly volatile moonshine, Steve.
Let me guess, that was after lunch, right?
As a matter of fact, it was, sugar. You know how hard it was? That hot copper in Memphis is hard to get full of the hens, too. Have you ever had to the City Hall?
Oh, yeah. I had this parking ticket once, and there was only one person in line at the DMV, even though there were positions for many more. They made me take a number.
You have a way to get to another planet? Well, hell, call the Army. Send the Marines.
It's a two-seater. Oh, I love sports cars.
Maybe we can send Superman and Chuck Norris.
We don't exactly have time for that.
What do you mean?
I mean, there's only a small window of opportunity that the celestial bodies will be properly aligned to ensure the journey's success.
I'm scared to ask, but when is this brief period of time?
Well, it started when I called you this morning. And it ends around supper time.
So it's now or never.
Pretty much.
Well, Professor, you and I can go. I'll drive.
We're doomed.
Yeah, that dog don't hunt. Hey, Clone Wars.
Hey, how about Gale and I? What do you think, Professor? We could go.
Sounds like a plan to me.
Oh, we're so doomed.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun.
Fine.
The spaceship's ready to go right now. Just cut through the genetics lab, go down the hall, go out the double doors. You can't miss it. It looks like a big spaceship.
Oh, excellent.
And if you hurry, I won't be late for supper.
Well, I can't wait, but I gotta go to the boys' room first. Hang on a second.
God, we're so freaking doomed.
Oh, it's you again.
Shut up. Stupid machine. upon completion, correct? And options on future projects? Excellent! Woohoo! Have I got things to do now?
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that today's episode of Zap Pronto, The Problem with Pergo, was brought to you by the Zap Pronto Posable Action Figure with Kung Fu Grip. Optional plug-in hybrid not included. And by Slugger Zap Figure with Home Run Swing Action and Real Leatherette Love from Blammo. Not suitable for children under 5, Zap Pronto does not condone the use of Kung Fu Grip for anything but last resort self-defense. Meanwhile, back on Pergo, there is discontent in the kingdom. The princess grows weary of her father's ways. All is not as it seems.
Princess, as directed, we have prepared your usual chambers.
Is everything okay?
Would you like to send in some thumbscrews?
Maybe a rack?
No. Perhaps a visit to the dungeon would cheer the princess.
Or maybe some pretty new shoes, maybe, with, like, spikes?
Your majestic wickedness, if there's anything at all we can do, we're at your command.
We throw ourselves at your mercy.
Mercy?
What are you saying?
Be gone, or I shall demonstrate my mercy.
Oh, man, I thought we were goddess for sure.
Shut up, you fool!
Google.
Sorry, miss. I was giving myself an oil job.
Are there any surveillance devices active in this room?
There are 42. Bring the size of a planet, and this is what she asked.
Disable them.
He won't let me do that.
Disable them? Override code poopsie.
Done. I think you ought to know that I'm feeling very depressed.
You think you're depressed?
Well, I'd give you advice, but you wouldn't listen. No one ever does.
Locusts die on a lawn tonight, not a minion to be seen. Kingdom of horror, torture, and one day, I'll be queen. My father's howling now, but I can't turn the thumbscrews. Couldn't water board. Heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the monster you've always had to be. Don't feel, fill them with woe. They'll scream and moan. Let them go, let them go. Can't torture them anymore. Let them go, let them go. Rule the meek and end the door. I have a degree in poli-sci. Let the torture end. Father never bothered me anyway.
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, today's episode of Zap Pronto, The Problem with Pergo, is also brought to you by Zap Pronto Jeans. Put a rocket in your pocket with a fit that lifts and separates. Zap Pronto Jeans, they're not just pants, they're a way of life. As the countdown begins, Zap and Gale settle in for the journey to Pergo. Our intrepid adventurers make lighthearted small talk to ease the transition of the trial that is to come.
You nervous?
Yes.
First time?
No, I've been nervous lots of times. Say, do you know how to fly this thing?
Not really.
I would think it's completely automatic.
No, it doesn't seem to be any kind of autopilot.
But you said you don't know how to fly it.
Well, it's never stopped me before.
What? Have you flown before?
Helicopters, gyrocopters.
Yeah, that's something.
Fighter planes, several 1- and 2-engine private aircraft.
I see.
Commercial airliners, a space shuttle.
Oh, really?
Some experimental aircraft, including one shaped like a flying saucer that let me borrow now and then. People love to take pictures of those.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, yeah, and a replica of Leonardo da Vinci's flying machine. That one was out of control.
You're pulling my leg.
No, I don't know what's pulling your leg, but it's not me.
When could you possibly have time to do it?
I'll see you then.
Okay, so you expect me to believe you just walk up to these people and ask to fly these things and they just let you.
No, they call me.
Oh, they call you?
Mm-hmm.
All right then, fly boy. Sprinkle some of your pixie dust on this thing and off we go.
Pixie dust?
Yeah, so your ears flapping, Dumbo.
My ears? But we don't...
I got it. To infinity and beyond.
Infinity? But we only have to
go... Splash off, space cowboy!
Oh, why didn't you say so? All right, I think I got this thing figured out.
Okay.
All right, three,
okay.
Two, one, blast off.
Well, that was a dud.
What do you mean?
We're not moving, Einstein.
Sure we are. Got the puddle on the floor.
Well, it doesn't feel like we're moving.
186,000 miles per second, according to the speedometer.
We are not!
Sure we are. Look at the stars.
Huh. What do you know? They're beautiful. Zap, it's you, it's me, it's the stars. What do you say you get that back seat look, you know what I mean?
It's a two-seater. It's like there's a plasma injector. I gotta check it out.
Oh, I'll check out that plasma injector for you. Oh, I thought you never ask. Say, what do I do if something happens?
Just wiggle the stick if it looks like you need to.
I can wiggle it all night long.
What was that?
Nothing.
Danger, Will Robinson!
Okay, so, alright. We've got to take a little detour around the black hole here. She also used to say that life is like a box of chocolates. Never really understood that one.
I bet.
I don't bet. It's no fun. I always win.
Heard any of those Zap Pronto jokes?
Jokes?
Yeah. Like, Superman wears Zap Pronto pajamas.
Does.
Zap Pronto counted to infinity twice.
That's a bit of an exaggeration.
Zap Pronto can slam a revolving door.
That one's been going around.
Zap Pronto. People that need you still remember Zap Pronto.
I've forgotten that one.
Zap Pronto eats lightning and barks thunder.
No, that's not true.
My favorite. Zap Pronto brought down the Berlin Wall.
Well, that one is true, but don't tell anyone. Berlin.
Oh, I can't believe I'm doing this. Zap. Do things really always go your way? Like, do things always turn out exactly how you expect? Because most of us spend our whole life wondering about what people think about us or who we're going to spend the rest of our life with.
Well, I never really plan anything. I just sort of deal with whatever comes up, and if I lose something, I stop looking for it, and there it is.
That sounds so simple.
The obstacle is the path itself. No snowflake will ever fall in the wrong place.
Thanks, Grasshopper.
You're welcome. Oh, there it is.
What?
Planet Pergo, dead ahead.
Oh, do you know how to land this thing? I don't answer that, actually. Do you think they know we're coming?
Oh, yes, they're right on our tail.
Oh, well, don't let them catch us.
Let's play. Hang on, we're going in. my eyes, thank you.
That wasn't so bad.
Yeah, but it looks like we're completely surrounded.
Will Zap and Gale be captured by the Emperor's minions? Will their attempts to save the Earth from global annihilation be thwarted before it even begins? Will the machinations of the evil overlord triumph over the forces of good? Tune in after the break for the thrilling conclusion to Zap Pronto, the problem with Pergo. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, today's episode is brought to you by Belcher Brewery. We invite you to enjoy their new Extreme Ultralight Lithuanian Microbrew Wheat Lager Stout Ale in the new 64-ounce wide-mouth mini-keg with a corkscrew top and chain-change label. Oh, yes, there's nothing like a Belcher's.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the thrilling conclusion to Zap Pronto, the problem with Pergo. Today's episode is brought to you by Belcher Brewery, who reminds you that when it's all about a cheap buzz, they're Belchers. Our heroes try desperately to evade capture as the evil overlord inexorably draws his net ever tighter. Will they escape his clutches? Or will they be cornered by the Emperor's dastardly minions? Let us watch and find out.
Do you think we lost all that?
No, I can hear them all around us, but for some reason they just haven't closed in.
Oh, I wish they would. This anticipation is killing me.
Oh, they'll be here when they get here.
Something doesn't eat us first.
They're more afraid of us than we are of them.
Yeah, I doubt it.
Maybe we should keep moving.
Well, do you have a plan?
No, but you seem less nervous when we're moving.
No, we just came from that way.
Ah, when you're surrounded, the only way to go is in circles.
Minox! Rankeillor! Wampus? Oh my. This is ridiculous. Wandering around in the boonies, looking for earthlings, no less. I never should have joined the minions. I don't even have health insurance. I don't have any friends, and I miss my family. Oh, there it goes. I'm never gonna stop crying down. My whole family is like this. We wear our hearts on our sleeves. I'm the worst of all, but this crab, he is the most hard-hearted thing there is. He is a rock, he is as cold as ice, and he has no more pity in him than a dog. When I left, a shark Dukan would have wept. Let me tell you how it was. This shoe is my father. No, this shoe is my father. No, that can't be it either. No, this shoe is my mother. No, that can't be it either. No, yes, it is my mother. It has less soul. So, the shoe that with the worn down soul on it is my mother, and then this shoe is my father. Damned if it isn't. Now, this shoe is my, is my sister because it is colorful and quite explosive, and I am the dog. No, the dog is me, and I am the dog. No, the dog is himself, and I am the dog. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so first thing I did is I went to my father, and he was crying, and he was sobbing, so I gave him a big old hug. And then I went to my mother. And I said, I said, Mother dearest, and she was weeping and wailing, and so I was gonna give her a big old kick. Well, no, that was my mother's breath, definitely, right there. Oh. And then can you hear my sister moan? And all the while, this dog does not shed a single tear. But I better get going, because if stick up his butt catches me goofing off, there'll be hell to pay. Come on, crab, you heartless mongrel. Now I am alone. Oh, what a rogue and peasant slave am I. Are you monologuing? Are you monologuing? You think you're a people? He thinks he's a people.
Where's that idiot? I'm never gonna rag the intruders if we don't work together. I cannot fathom why they sent one with a towering intellect such as mine. Such a brutish mission. He kind of thug is capable of subduing a couple of earthlings. And that add insult to the matter, they would only allow me this. This puny excuse for a weapon. Yes, I know it's not the size that matters and how you use it. It's my experience that size still matters. I've heard tale of the little blue pellet that magically enlarges your weapon. But the armory is bristling with so many exquisitely large weapons. Weapons of mass destruction. Lovely barrels glistening with gun oil of such a size that a single beam
about me? The noisy cricket. So here I am, scouring the wasteland with just this tiny toy. How pathetic. Because of that one little incident on Murktroyd. Even though the Emperor was never very fond of that horta. Can't even find my stupid partner. Where is that idiot?
Freeze!
Watch where you're pointing that thing, you fool!
You were goofing off! I caught you goofing off!
No, I was calculating my next move.
No, you weren't. You were just standing there talking to yourself.
I was considering all possible strategies.
No, look, I know goofing off when I see it. I'm sort of an expert.
Have you seen any sign of the intruders?
No, no, it's okay. It's okay. Mind if I join you?
I have employed search pattern delta in Sector C. Where have you searched?
Over there? Do you want to play cards? We could sing some songs.
Be quiet!
Kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya.
Shut up!
Someone's grumpy, my lord, kumbaya.
I will shoot you. I hear something, you bubble brain.
Huh?
Perhaps it's the intruders we seek.
Where?
Hard to say with all that racket you were making. Perhaps in that direction.
Of today's program is Zap Pronto Insurance. Buy it and you'll never need it. Guaranteed. Meanwhile, back at the palace, the Emperor and his daughter plot the particulars of how to probe the prisoners concerning the purpose of their pilgrimage. What foul fate will fulminate from their furtive formulations? Let us find out.
I have always favored physical torture, followed by the signing of a confession.
Father, you're so old-fashioned. Thumbscrews and such, really?
There are reasons. They are classics.
But there are so many more effective methods.
Bah! Unproven.
I have made an extensive study of many new interrogation techniques, some which have proven to be far more effective when applied in the proper manner.
Smoke and mirrors, new age crap. Give me a hot poker any day.
Pain is not always the best motivator. Many subjects experience a heightened sense of heroism and an anticipation of martyrdom that inhibits the sharing of information. Others make things up just to get you to stop. It's really counterproductive.
Who cares about the information? I already know what I need to know.
But Father, so much wasted profit potential.
Okay, okay, okay. What do you suggest?
Well, let's see. There are truth serums so powerful that they can make a Ferengi tell you where the Latin is hidden.
But these are human earthlings. Who knows if their body chemistry is compatible? Let's not turn this into a science experiment. You remember what happened on Omega 3 when you used your subjugation spray on the entire planet?
Yes, they're still deliriously happy for no reason. But on the bright side, it ended that rebellion.
Disgusting.
All right, Father, you have a point. We don't know what the effect would be on Earthlings. Perhaps a more subtle psychological approach is in order. Sensory deprivation over an extended period of time has proved to make subjects very talkative.
Oh, I have no patience for that. And ditto for sleep deprivation or dripping water on the forehead.
An instant gratification junkie, are we?
Call it what you will. Now, shall we dust off the rack? Or maybe do a little waterboarding?
Father, you're intractable. I say you can't teach an old griplaw new tricks?
I say, don't mess with success.
Father, don't you want to try something new? How boring it must be to follow the same routine day after day.
It worked for my father and his father before him.
Yes, I know, tradition. But Father, you have to get with the times. Things can change. Things can be better.
Oh, people don't change. They're the same as they ever were.
All right. I will show you. How about a contest?
What do you propose?
We each take one of the prisoners and interrogate them in our methods of choice. Then compare results. I'm sure I can achieve much better results.
Sounds like fun.
But Father, you can't kill them.
I tell you what, I won't even touch them.
Really?
But I get to pick which one to start with.
It's a deal. Bring it on.
Oh, so you bring it on. Bringing the prisoners!
Zap Pronto.
Excuse me, if you could get on your knees right there.
Oh.
Just right there.
Sure.
These are the intruders. I was expecting something more menacing.
The big one looks interesting.
Indeed. Did they put up much of a fight?
I mean, it took us a while to fire.
They were even awed by our superiority and surrendered.
Actually, it was just the quickest way.
Oh, wait, are you seriously trying to tell me that?
Silence! We know why you are here. We have tracked you from that backwater planet you call Earth. What you don't understand is how you propose to achieve your objective without any obvious means. Either you are very foolish, or there's more to Earthlings than I thought.
I'm thinking the foolish one fits.
Tell me, on your world, are you warriors?
Well, I'm a baseball player.
Oh, yes, I've heard of this silly game. Are you a baseball player as well?
No. I'm a reporter. I write the news.
Oh, a government propaganda officer?
Oh, we have free press where I'm from, Princess.
Ridiculous! They've sent a boy who plays a silly game and a subversive writer to challenge the mighty Emperor of Dawn, the merciless absolute ruler of 12 galaxies.
Quiet, peon!
They arrived in a rather advanced spacecraft. It'd be wise not to underestimate them. I can have them disintegrated immediately.
You may have a point.
I think there might be something to be gained from a thorough interrogation.
You have only to ask.
Hey, traitor! Yes, I'll take the big one.
Are you forgetting I get to choose first? Yeah, I choose the fiery one.
Good choice. Minion, bring the big one to my chambers while I prepare.
Be strong, Zap.
The strongest tree is the one that bends in the wind.
All is proceeding as planned. I must prepare as well. You. Make sure this one doesn't leave the room until I come and get her.
So don't leave the room even if you come and get her.
No. Until I come and get her.
Until you come and get her, I'm not to enter the room.
No. You stay here and make sure she doesn't leave.
And you'll come and get her.
Right.
So I don't need to do anything other than stopping her from entering the room.
No. Leaving the room.
Leaving the room, yes.
All right?
Right. But now
Yes, what is it?
Look,
it's quite simple. You stay here and make sure she doesn't leave the room, all right?
Oh, now I remember now. Can she leave the room with me?
No. Just keep her in here and make sure...
Well, I mean, of course we'll keep her in here, obviously. But like, let's say like she had to leave with me and like...
No. Just keep her in here.
Until you or anyone else...
No! No one else! Just me!
Just you.
Get back. All right?
Right. We'll stay here until you get back.
And make sure she doesn't leave.
What?
Make sure she doesn't leave.
Her?
Yes, make sure she doesn't leave!
I thought you meant the computer. I was like, what? Pardon the computer? Okay.
Is that clear?
Yeah, quite clear, no problem.
Oh. All right.
What the heck?
Where are you going?
I'm coming with you!
No! I want you to stay here and make sure she doesn't leave! just get her a glass of water or something?
That guy.
What? Man. And with the neck.
And twice.
Yeah, twice. Man, we'll have a seat, relax. So what's your name?
Ah, who wants to know?
I do. My name is Emo Sasius Maximonus, but they call me Emo.
Oh. Gale. Gale artist name, reporting to the game. I can't say I'm glad to meet you, Emo.
Oh, come on, I'm not a bad guy. Don't let the blaster fool ya.
You're the minion to Emo Emperor Overlord.
Well, I guess you got me there. Oh. What was that cute noise you were making? Yeah, that. Yeah.
Hiccups. I sometimes get them when I'm nervous.
Well, don't be nervous. I'm not going to hurt you.
You see, I'm always a little bit nervous right before being interrogated by a tyrant.
One second. 4, 8, 15, 16, 23, 42.
What was all that about?
I don't know, you just gotta put in the numbers when it does that.
What happens if you don't?
I don't know, something bad. I'm not a scientist. I like that stuff that's on your head. It's really beautiful.
Do the women on your planet not have hair? What do they have? Tentacles or something?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, well, that must be interesting.
Not really. I mean, they tend to eat their mates with their tentacles, like a, like.
Well, tell me about it.
I'd rather not, if that's okay.
Yeah, I haven't had the best of luck with relationships either. But anyway, so if you're such a nice guy, what are you doing here?
It's a recession, you know, and it's the only job a guy with a philosophy degree could get.
I guess it's tough all over.
It's not so bad. I meet people like you. That's pretty cool.
Oh, you're just saying that.
Nah, mostly I spend my time with a horrible Speck.
What's a Speck?
He's a ridiculously logical being with a tiny little blaster.
I know all about that type.
Tell me about it.
I'd rather not.
That's a good one. The witty, the sardonic. It's good.
Mr. Nice Guy, why don't you look the other way while I just, like, slip on out of here, right?
I mean, you're really brave and all, but, yeah. Like, there's some really, like, mean stuff out there, so, like, I really wouldn't.
Crap, today is turning out to be such a disaster.
I'm sorry. You know what always makes me feel better, though?
I can't even imagine.
Ice cream.
What?
Yeah, we got the idea from your Earthling transmissions. My favorite flavor is moose tracks, and I don't know what a moose is, but its tracks are delicious.
So, you got ice cream?
Yeah, you want some?
Yeah, it's one of my guilty pleasures.
Okay, after you.
Oh, ice cream with an alien. They will never print that one.
Today's episode of Zap Pronto was also brought to you by Zap Pronto Cologne. Who are you and what are your dreams? Zap Pronto has the answer, and it smells like love. Zap Pronto Cologne is available in rest stop vending machines everywhere. Our dashing hero is brought to the Princess's Chamber for interrogation. Will Zap be able to resist the most advanced techniques in 12 galaxies? Or will the minion take it upon itself to rid the Empire of the threat before she even arrives?
This is where you will await your fate.
Thank you.
Shall we play a game?
No. You don't seem concerned. Do you not understand that the princess is a master of interrogation techniques?
Well, if you understand, things are just as they are. If you do not understand, things are still just as they are.
So, ignorance is bliss. I do not find that to be a function of philosophy. Being unaware of potential events does not prevent their occurrence nor reduce the suffering that follows. Indeed, it can be argued that only by being aware of all possible features and their probabilities can one prepare for or predict undesirable outcomes.
Nonsense. You can't possibly predict all futures. Their number is infinite, so why worry about it?
You are mistaken. There is much to worry about. The probability is extremely high that you will not leave this room, at least not with your mind intact.
I'll let you dwell on that since you seem to enjoy it.
I enjoy nothing.
That does not surprise me.
I'm merely fascinated by your indifference. To what do you owe this attitude? Do you believe some deity will protect you or reward your martyrdom?
My mom always told me that it's not polite to discuss politics or religion.
What is your mama?
Oh, one of my two parents. The one that gave birth to me.
You know your biological progenitors?
Yes, of course. They raised me until I could take care of myself. But don't you know your parents?
I think not. How revolting.
The interview is getting clearer and clearer.
I was raised from educated from birth in a communal crèche. It is much more efficient. I am the proud product of Alpha Zeta Alpha, a most prestigious upbringing.
And they taught you to be arrogant and evil.
On the contrary, they taught me that the concept of good and evil is an artificial construct, created by illogical beings in power in order to control other illogical beings. When logic prevails, there is no need for such.
Nonsense. There's more to life than logic. It takes heart, soul, and mind to create a complete person. One beam alone, no matter how stout, cannot support house.
Logic prevails. The most logical action is always the correct action.
There, you see, you've made my point. Your value system determines the relative logic of various actions and decides that only one of them is correct. In your case, good and logical are synonymous. For the rest of us, good isn't necessarily logical.
Erroneous!
Furthermore, I believe that no matter what kind of creature you are, or what kind of value system you believe in, there's a fundamental basis for good and evil.
And what, pray tell, is that basis?
The nature of good is creation and order. The nature of evil is destruction and chaos. Tell me, do you consider destruction to be inherently logical?
Fascinating rhetoric, but it will not save you from your fate!
Now fate, I don't believe in.
Whatever your plan is, it will not succeed. I am watching you. My vigilance will not waver.
I'll put that little thing away.
The noisy cricket is capable of short-circuiting all of your neural pathways.
I'll put that little thing away.
Your Highness, I would not take this one lightly. His confidence implies he is reason to believe survival is possible.
Are you questioning my command?
Your Highness, I am not. I am merely offering my observations and suggesting the most logical response, disintegration.
If I want your opinion, peon, I will ask. For it. Step aside. I can handle this one.
Hello again.
The minion is correct. You seem very calm for someone in your current situation.
We cannot see our reflection in running water. It's only in still water that we can see.
A student of Zap to the Budarian?
Nope, never heard of him or her.
I suppose not on that backwater planet of yours. It is no matter. Your philosophy will not protect you in the face of evil that knows no bounds.
Philosophy is but the smile on a dog. Kissera, sera.
Whatever will be, will be. You have no control over the situation.
Control is an illusion.
Yes, yes, but there is a man in there somewhere. A man with desires. What do you desire? What makes you tick? Are you a passionless drum like that minion over there professes to be? Or is there a fire down below?
Well, I've never had any complaints.
I bet you haven't. Shall we see if we can unleash the beast? This is my latest experiment in interrogation techniques. Prepare yourself. No one has resisted yet.
Okey-dokey.
Seen anything so beautiful, and you have such long, elegant white fangs.
Then you'll tell me whatever I want to know, and do whatever I ask?
Yes, yes, of course, but first, tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm a Gemini. And I think that explains a lot about me.
Don't forget that Belcher Brewery brings you this episode of Zap Pronto. Belcher Beer, the beer that made Alabaster famous. Meanwhile, back in the throne room, Gale is waiting with great trepidation for one of the Emperor's infamous interrogations. Will she crack? Will the Emperor uphold his promise to the princess? Only time will tell.
Just yet. I'm getting some strange vibrations from the Emperor. I don't think everything is as it seems.
Oh, vibrations.
Yeah, my people are very sensitive to the moods of others.
You mean you can read minds?
No, just emotional states. And like right now what I'm getting from the Emperor is more like fatherly than bloodthirsty. Like, I guess it could be just that the princess is here, but I feel like it's more than that.
So, can you read my emotions?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, dear.
Well, that's why I like you so much. I can tell what's going on under the facade.
I don't know how I feel about that.
I do.
Just my luck. I meet a great guy who likes me for the real me just before being tortured to death.
Well, the princess is really interested in that big one, so, like, I don't think she's going to let anything happen to you.
Well, I hope you're right. But if you're not, it's been nice meeting you, even.
Prepare yourself, Earthling!
Oh, yeah. Oh. Ah!
Are you ready for the singular honor of being interrogated by the Emperor Dung, the merciless absolute ruler of 12 galaxies?
Remember, the princess wants information, not blood!
Do you think I need to be reminded by the likes of you?
Hey, don't talk to him that way.
No, brave talk. Shall we see if we can break that strong will of yours?
Oh, better men than you have tried, buddy.
Yes, we shall soon see, won't we?
You could just try asking her. She might just tell you.
What would be the fun in that? Besides, we wouldn't be sure if it was the truth or not. You can never trust what they say until they have been properly softened up. But once the will has been stripped away, then, and only then, can they be trusted to speak the truth.
I don't much like the sound of that.
No, deliciously understated, my dear. I can feel the anticipation building. I believe I can sense the beginnings of wild animal panic.
I know I do.
All right, well, quit talking about it. Let's get on with it. Come on, Grand Poobah, give me your best shot.
Oh, don't try to goad me into rash action. I've been this a long time. I'm going to take my time and enjoy this. My first shall begin with a reading from the Vogon Pathetic
Pause. No, no, no.
Futile.
No, not Vogon poetry.
Poetry?
Not just any poetry, it's the worst poetry in the universe.
Yes, be afraid. Be very afraid.
You can't, you can't do that. The last time the Pathetic Putz poem was read aloud, all of the Alturian lemmings in the universe threw themselves off a cliff.
I have activated the cone of silence. That means only those in this room will be exposed to the most toxic verses ever uttered. You may leave if you wish.
Oh.
Very well then. Prepare yourself. Small lump of putty, green and found in my armpit. I shall snarf it down. Well, you appear to be unaffected, but let's see if you are still in possession of your mental facilities. What did you think of the poem?
Well, I thought it had some interesting transmetaphorical imagery, but the little bit about the ball of putty, I found it to be merely a shallow reflection of the mid-20th century German nihilist.
Huh?
Oh, you put on a brave front, Earthling. But my next selection was banned on the Vogon home planet for being used as a weapon of mass destruction. It was smuggled to me by a deaf, dumb, and blind kid by the name of Tommy. Oh, how he loved pinball. From the slimy branches the gray drips drop, and the raw wind windshines in the thin tree top, and my heart shrieks die, and my love from me it flies. My thought is running out of my head. My soul runs after and leaves me dead.
All right.
Still no reaction. Perhaps I have underestimated Earthlings. Did you not find this verse revolting down to the very core of your being?
No. I was the editor of my high school literary journal.
I must look into this literary journal.
Your Majesty, may I have a word with you?
You know I am not to be interrupted when I'm engaged in torture... enhanced interrogation.
I have news of events you may find interesting.
Oh, very well, then it better be.
Are you all right?
I was able to focus in on your incredibly ambivalent emotional state. And I was able to endure. You're amazing.
Oh, you're very brave.
monsters in the tower and bring the princess to me.
The tower? Don't you mean the dungeon?
I will not tolerate any more insolence. Shall I return you to the swamp where I found you?
No, sir.
I do not harm them. Very interesting.
I assume the speck has been here filling your ears with its vile lies.
Shall we go out onto the balcony and discuss my displeasure?
But you don't believe that cockroach, do you?
And what do you suppose these lies to be, if they are nothing but fabrication? How do you know that you even object?
Oh, I'm gonna get that little man!
This episode of Zap Pronto was also brought to you by Zap Pronto Dating Service. All you have to do to find your perfect mate is to stop looking elsewhere. Log on to zapthelovemachine.com and sign up today, then zap. There you are, your perfect mate and pronto.
Here you will await your doom.
Don't say it like that, doom.
Just, you know, the logical conclusion to the scenario.
You wouldn't.
Say, what did he mean when he'd say put you back in that swamp and he found you?
I was banished there, wrongfully.
Banished? For what?
For the last time, he was saying his maximus, I do not wish to discuss it!
Oh, I bet it had something to do with burning!
Hey, can you get us out of here?
Your fate is at the Emperor's discretion. Now I must leave.
What was that all about?
Oh, it's complicated.
Complicated? Well, all we have is time.
But it's a long story.
Journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Oh, God, enough. The Zen quote's already Gandhi.
Gandhi was a Hindu, not a Buddhist.
Okay, well, anyway, so me and Emo. Yeah, that's his name. When he and I, we survived the dreadful poetry by the Emperor. We had ice cream. Like, I think he was the same way about me. That my humor's a lot. I really like it. We're like, ah! It's so crazy. It's a lot with an alien. Like, I never would have thought something like this would have happened.
See, I told you, stop looking and you'll find it.
You did, but, what do we do now?
We wait.
I'm not real good at that.
Yes, I've noticed.
And say, you don't look any worse for the wear. How did things go with the princess?
I'm completely in her thrall.
You're kidding, right?
No. She's my sun, my moon, my starlit sky. She's the yin to my yang. She's the light at the end of my tunnel. She's the wind beneath my wings.
My goodness. That must have been some real brainwashing.
My mind is my own, but my heart is not.
Oh, yeah. We're a pair, aren't we?
Yes, two are a pair.
So, we wait.
We wait.
Heard any good jokes lately?
Eva!
Oopsie.
Don't call me that.
I have replaced the sound monitor for this room with a record of snoring.
Oh, good thinking.
I got the idea from Mission Impossible, or was it Hogan's Heroes?
Hey, if we can get to the ship, we can get the heck out of here.
Hey, no, you two go. I'm going to stay here with Poopsie.
If anyone else calls me that, I'm going to kill you.
No, Zap, I wouldn't go right leaving you here.
Oh, that's all right. No matter where you go, there you are.
You're very wise. Besides, your ship wouldn't make it very far. The Emperor's air defenses have been on high alert since your arrival.
So? What's the plan?
Plan?
Well, there are vast catacombs hidden beneath this palace. We can hide you there and launch your ship on autopilot. The ship would be shot down, but they'll assume you were destroyed with it.
Hey, Zap, I thought you said the ship didn't have an autopilot.
Oh, it did, but I just didn't feel like using it at the time.
Man, that's why I like aliens.
Okay, well, that sounds like a plan. You guys enter the catacombs, and I'll handle the ship.
No!
It is as you suggested.
Of course it is. My reasoning is infallible. After witnessing this afternoon's events and seeing this one sneaking from the barracks, there was only one logical conclusion.
I don't know what to talk about. talking about? I mean, I was just engaged in a little late-night interrogation and brought the minion along for self-defense.
Preposterous! Sire, surely you understand how ridiculous that sounds.
Calm yourself, peon. I know what's going on. I am not blind.
But, Daddy, there's nothing going on. I don't know what he's talking about.
Please. I know all about midnight interrogations. How do you think I met your mother?
Shall I disintegrate them now, sir? Would you like to wait for the spectacle of a public execution?
When I want your suggestions, I will ask for them. You have overstepped your boundaries for the last time, lackey. And as for you four, there is only one way to deal with this.
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that today's episode of Zap Pronto was brought to you by Belcher Brewery. For the very best beer goggles, there's nothing like a Belcher. Will, the mighty galactic overlord, has him discreetly done away with to cover the ignominy of his daughter's betrayal? Or will he make dealing with him a public display? Can Zap still find some way to escape whatever fate has been decreed? All will be revealed in the final chapter of Zap Pronto.
Citizens of Pergo, I call upon you to gather in order to bear witness to today's events. Monumental events that shall go down in the annals of galactic history. Events that you will remember all your lives. Tales of this day shall be passed down for generations until the end of time. Come! Behold the spectacle. And you, Zap Pronto, promise to do as the princess wishes for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
You better lest you incur my wrath.
Father, please.
Do you, Poopsie, promise to let me know if this one gives you any trouble?
Yes, Father.
And to call your father at least once a week, no matter what?
Yes, Father.
And do you, or whatever your name is, take this hot-blooded earthling to be your partner for as long as you both can stand each other?
Yes, Your Majesty.
And do you, who shrugs off low-gone poetry as if it were merely words, take this inept minion to be your mate?
I do.
And do you promise not to make a meal out of him?
Yeah, I do.
If there is anyone here who objects to these proceedings, he had better keep it to themselves. By the power vested in me as the supreme ruler of 13 galaxies, yes, I said 13, I can't really Samsung Galaxy, last night I was between Valentine's Day. Yes. By the power vested in me, I pronounce you pair bonded. And now, the new Prince of Pergo will address the people.
Well, I don't really know what to say.
Oh, give him one of your profound sayings, Zap.
Excellent. In the words of the immortal Dr. Seuss, be who you are and say what you mean and feel, because those who matter don't mind, and those who mind don't matter.
Aw, that's the first thing you ever said that made sense.
Thank you. Well, I'm sorry that you're going back to the swamp.
I understand there's opportunity there. The mud has been discovered to have some medicinal qualities, and civilization is beginning to emerge.
Well, I mean, it's, you know, dangerous with what all this giant slime monsters and stuff like that, so I'd like you to have something. I'd like you to have my crab.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, really.
Really?
Yeah.
Is the house broken or is he gonna leave little batteries on the floor?
I wish you luck.
I appreciate it so much.
I know.
Married!
Woohoo! And we did it, didn't we, Dre?
Yes.
As I promised, I was able to locate the perfect man for your daughter. Although I'm still a tad confuzzled as to why all the elaborate deception was actually needed.
You don't understand, my daughter. If she found out that this was all my idea, nothing would have happened.
I know. It went Interstellar E-rated.
And I did lose a couple of minions.
You're not trying to back out of our little agreement, are you?
No, of course not. Tell me, could you actually build an interstellar heat ray?
Well, it is theoretically possible, I suppose, given the adequate funding. Speaking of which, you still owe me 10,000 bars of platinum.
And this 10,000 should cover our expenses?
Our